Oxygen is an essential element for many physiological processes in the human body. As it's transported through the bloodstream, it fuels our cells and organs, allowing them to perform their necessary functions. Which is why it's important to note that a decline in blood oxygen levels can lead to unfortunate health issues, ranging from fatigue and shortness of breath to more severe conditions such as respiratory failure. However, the good news is that there are some practical, actionable steps that you can implement to naturally boost your blood oxygen levels, which is exactly what we are going to cover in this video. Keep watching until the end because there's one method that I think will surprise you. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. The first natural method to increase oxygen levels involves plants. Because plants can naturally improve indoor air quality and increase oxygen levels by converting carbon dioxide into oxygen through the process of photosynthesis. Which is why incorporating plants like snake plants, areca palms, and spider plants into your living space can help boost the oxygen content in your environment, making it easier to breathe and promoting overall well-being. Next up is exercise. Regular physical activity improves cardiovascular health and lung capacity, which in turn can increase blood oxygen levels. Engaging in aerobic exercises like brisk walking, jogging, swimming, or cycling helps strengthen the respiratory muscles, enhances oxygen delivery to tissues, and promotes efficient use of oxygen within the body. The next method on our list is deep breathing, which is a simple yet effective way to increase blood oxygen levels. By consciously taking slow, deep breaths, you can expand your lungs to their full capacity, allowing for greater oxygen intake and improved oxygen exchange. Deep breathing also helps strengthen the respiratory muscles and improves overall lung function, leading to better oxygen absorption and distribution throughout the body. Another important thing to consider is your climate, because it can significantly impact blood oxygen levels due to various factors such as altitude, humidity, and air quality. Higher altitudes typically have lower air pressure and reduced oxygen content. The body often adapts to these conditions over time, but some individuals may experience altitude sickness or struggle with acclimation. Dry climates can affect the respiratory system by causing dehydration and increasing the risk of airway irritation. Therefore, maintaining proper hydration and using a humidifier can help counteract these effects. In addition, poor air quality, often resulting from pollution or other environmental contaminants, can also adversely affect blood oxygen levels. If you inhale polluted air, your lungs must work harder to filter out harmful particles and gases, potentially impairing the exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide in the blood. The next method involves posture, because maintaining good posture is essential for supporting efficient lung function and promoting healthy blood oxygen levels. Poor posture, such as slouching or hunching over, can restrict the chest cavity and limit lung expansion, reducing the volume of oxygen that can be inhaled. By consciously adopting an upright posture with shoulders back, chest open, and spine aligned, you create more space for your lungs to expand, allowing for more effective breathing and better oxygen absorption. The next method, which I had to include in this video, is to stop smoking. Smoking is a major contributor to poor respiratory health as it damages lung tissue and impedes the exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide. Quitting smoking can significantly improve lung function, increase blood oxygen levels, and reduce the risk of developing respiratory diseases such as COPD or lung cancer. There are numerous smoking cessation aids and support systems available to help individuals quit smoking and improve their overall health. Another important consideration is your diet. Consuming a well-balanced diet that includes iron-rich foods, antioxidants, and essential nutrients can support the body's ability to transport and utilize oxygen. Iron is a critical component of hemoglobin, the protein in red blood cells responsible for carrying oxygen. Foods such as spinach, red meat, lentils, and fortified cereals can boost iron levels and help improve oxygen transportation. Additionally, incorporating antioxidants like vitamin C, E, and beta carotene can help protect cells from damage caused by free radicals generated during oxygen metabolism. The next method on our list involves breathing exercises. Incorporating specific breathing exercises such as pursed lip breathing and diaphragmatic breathing can help improve respiratory function and increase blood oxygen levels. Pursed lip breathing involves inhaling through the nose and exhaling slowly through pursed lips, which helps regulate breaths, prolong exhalation, and increase the amount of oxygen that reaches the lungs. Diaphragmatic breathing, also known as belly breathing, focuses on engaging the diaphragm during inhalation, allowing for deeper breaths and more efficient oxygen exchange. Practicing these techniques regularly can help enhance lung capacity, optimize blood oxygenation, and promote overall respiratory health. Next up is hydration. Poor hydration plays a vital role in maintaining healthy blood oxygen levels, as water is essential for optimal lung function and blood circulation. Drinking adequate amounts of water helps to thin mucus lining in the airways, making it easier for the lungs to clear out any debris or pathogens. Furthermore, staying hydrated ensures an efficient blood volume, which in turn promotes effective oxygen transportation throughout the body. Another thing that can affect blood oxygen levels is obesity. That is because excess body weight can put additional pressure on the respiratory system, resulting in reduced lung capacity. Obesity is often associated with a higher risk of developing respiratory issues such as sleep apnea, asthma, and COPD, all of which can lead to lower blood oxygen levels. So by adopting a healthy lifestyle that includes regular exercise and a well-balanced diet, individuals can work towards achieving a healthy weight, which in turn can help improve lung function, increase oxygen saturation, and reduce the risk of respiratory complications. Next up on our list is in regard to lung infections. Lung infections, including pneumonia and bronchitis, can compromise the respiratory system's ability to efficiently exchange oxygen and carbon dioxide, resulting in reduced blood oxygen levels. Prompt diagnosis and appropriate treatment, including antibiotics, antiviral medications, or other therapeutic modalities, are essential to combat the infection and restore proper lung function. Additionally, taking preventative measures, such as practicing good hand hygiene and maintaining a strong immune system, can help minimize the risk of developing lung infections and contribute to the preservation of healthy blood oxygen levels. So as you can see, understanding and prioritizing the importance of blood oxygenation is crucial for maintaining good health and well-being. By implementing these natural strategies, anyone can effectively increase their blood oxygen levels. However, there are times when natural methods simply aren't enough, such as in emergency situations or in cases of severe hypoxemia. This requires immediate medical intervention that will usually involve some form of supplemental oxygen therapy. Oxygen therapy is a medical treatment prescribed to individuals with hypoxemia, a condition characterized by low blood oxygen levels. This can result from various conditions such as COPD, asthma, sleep apnea, or lung infections. Oxygen therapy helps improve blood saturation by providing additional oxygen through various devices such as nasal cannulas, oxygen masks, or portable oxygen concentrators. Just remember that it is important to follow a healthcare professional's recommendations regarding the appropriate use and duration of supplemental oxygen therapy to ensure optimal results and avoid potential complications. Severe oxygenation issues may require intubation and support from a mechanical ventilator, which can deliver oxygen levels up to 100%. If you want to support the channel, please like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. And there should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you will enjoy. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friend.